Hello students, in lesson number 10, light, reflection and refraction, let us move further. First one, we are going to learn about the phenomena which is very common, that is reflection of light. What do we mean by reflection of light? Reflection means whenever the rays of light incident on any surface, that light bounces back. Okay, if the surface is not transparent, then the light incident on it, most of the light will bounce back on the same medium, right? So this phenomena of bouncing back light, this phenomena we are calling it reflection. There are mainly two types of reflection, uniform reflection and non-uniform reflection. What is uniform reflection? Whenever the parallel rays of light, see, from the source of light, okay, from the source, the light rays emerges, originates from a source of light. After some distance, the rays of light are parallel, okay. So, when every time we take from far distance from the source, the rays of light becomes parallel, okay. So, the rays of light coming, let us say from sun, so when they reach on earth, the rays of light will be parallel. So a parallel rays of light incident on any surface, this is a very shiny and completely flat surface, okay. So any mirror surface or glass surface will be shiny and flat, okay. So when rays of parallel beam of light incident on any surface, this is a glass surface, let us say. So, and at the back side of the glass surface, a opaque coating is done, okay? Because we don't, if it is transparent glass, then the light will pass through it, but it is not transparent, it is made opaque by the coating at the back side. So, this light shows the coating, opaque coating. Okay? This can be done by any paint or anything. So when parallel beam of light incident on any surface, if it is flat surface, then the reflected ray will be parallel. Okay? Where parallel beam of light incident and it reflects in a same manner, that is parallel manner, then this kind of reflection will be a uniform reflection. But when parallel beam of light incident on uneven surface, okay, so due to this uneven surface, the ray of light will reflect in any direction, okay, so will not be parallel. So this kind of reflection will be non-uniform reflection. That is, I am giving the example of both the reflection. The rays reflected from a glass surface will be uniform reflection, and for us, when the rays of light incident on, let us say, book or walls or even V, that will be the non-uniform reflection. See, the books or walls looks flat, but atomically they are very uneven, okay? They are not completely flat. So they reflect the light in all the directions. That is why, that is the reason why when the rays of light coming from a window, that spreads in all the, because the walls reflect the light in all the direction, okay, that will be the non-uniform reflection. So, two type of reflection, uniform and non-uniform reflection. Now, but in both the reflection, both the type of reflection, the laws of reflection are obeyed. What are the laws of reflection? We have already learned it. Two laws of reflection are there. We are very familiar with it. The first law is the incident angle is equal to reflection angle. But let us see this terminology related to reflection. What is incident angle? I am considering a flat surface in which a ray of light is incidenting. The point at which the ray of light incident, it is called point of incidence. Okay, so this point is a point of incidence. And so at that point, a perpendicular line is drawn. Okay, so a perpendicular line at the point of incident is called normal. Normal means perpendicular. So a perpendicular line is drawn at the point of incident. So incident ray makes the angle with normal, that angle will be the incident angle. Okay, understand this? With normal, the incident ray makes the angle, that angle will be the incident angle I. And the ray will reflect back in this direction. So a reflected ray makes the angle with the normal, that angle will be the reflection angle. So for a reflection, angle of incident is always equal to angle of reflection. Okay, so I is equal to R. If angle I is 30 degree, then the angle R, that means reflection angle, will also be 30 degree. Okay, so this is the first law of reflection. It is obeyed for both the type of reflection. Okay, because at uneven, whatever angle it will make on this uneven surface, obeying the laws of reflection, it will make the same angle with the incidence and the light ray will reflect. Okay, here also. Based on the incident angle, the reflection angle will be there. And the second law, incident ray, reflected ray and normal lie in the same plane. Okay, so it means that on this surface of this board, the incident angle, ray, normal and reflection ray will lie on the same plane. So it doesn't happen that the ray of light incident here and comes back in another direction. Okay, on the other another plane. Always we can draw a plane. We can pass a plane, a surface from this incident ray, reflected ray and the normal. Okay, so this is the laws of reflection. Now, in this chapter, we are going to learn about the image formation. Okay, and this image formation is done by reflection first and then refraction. By both this phenomena, when light is going through this both phenomena, reflection and refraction, it will make the image. Okay, so, but before that, let us learn what is image formation. See, when we see any object, when we see the bench or trees or anything around us, what happens? When we see this object, the light incident on this object, that object reflects the light and that reflected ray enters in our eyes. Okay, so in our eyes, the image of that object is formed. Understand carefully. The reflected ray makes the image in our eyes and that image will be interpreted by the brain. Okay, so if we see the plant, if we see the tree, then the image of tree will be formed inside our eyes and that image will be interpreted by the brain and then brain will understand that yes, this is tree. So how this image is formed and how, why the light is forming, how this light forming the image, okay? See, so what do we mean by image formation? A very simple definition of image formation. When the rays of light originate from any point, okay, so that point will be any object. So when the ray of light originates from any point, meet at any other point, okay? Okay, this rays of light originates from one point and meet at any other point, then the image of the first point is formed on the other point. Okay, so the point from where the light is originated, when this rays meet at the other point, the image of first point is formed on the other point. A simple illustration of this statement we can understand by this figure. Let us say point A is a source, okay, from which the light, it's not always be the source of light, like see, sun is a source of light, tube light, lamp, okay, electric bulb. So this all are the source of light. But here, light originates from the source. We mean that it is not always be the source of light. See, we can, any object can also be the source of light. Why? Because when light incident on us, we reflect light in all the directions. So we can be, the light reflects from us, so we can also be the source of light. Second, so light is originates from, not when light reflected from us, so we can say that the rays are originates from us. So when the rays originates from one point, if they meet on any other point, let us say point B, then the image of A is formed on point B. So, but the question is how they are meeting. Why the rays of light meet on that other point? This problem is solved by the two phenomena, that is reflection and refraction. Okay, so there the light rays will meet by either by reflection or by refraction. So whenever the rays of light meet, we are not here getting any, we are not here worrying about how they are meeting. We are simply here understanding that when the rays of light meet on that point, the light will be. So here we have to do only one thing. We have to meet the rays of light. Okay? Just the light rays should be meet on any point. On that point, the image of the first point is formed. Okay? From any point, the light is originated from all, in all three directions, but for image formation we can consider only two rays. Okay? So from two rays, wherever they meet, the image of this center. So for our convenience, we consider only two rays for the image formation. Further, we are going to learn about the image formation by plane mirror. Okay? So we have seen our image in a mirror. How this image is formed in the mirror? Okay, by the simple, as we have learned that the point, the light rays originate from one point, they meet on the other point, and that is how the image will be formed. So how this plane mirror forms the image? We have seen this, our image inside the mirror, right? And if you have learned that there are two types of image, virtual image and real image. So what kind of image is formed by mirror? Virtual image. Okay, so let us learn how the image is formed. Here, consider one plane mirror. Okay, it is coated on the back side so that lines showing the coating. So here, this is plane mirror. An object put in front of the, it is kept in front of the mirror. So we are trying to get the image of point A. So point A can be the source of light for us. Now the light rays incident on this object will reflect in all the directions. But for the image formation, we consider only two rays. Okay, any random two rays we can consider. So here, first one, we are considering a light ray which is traveling normally to the mirror. Okay, so this one first light ray we are considering which incident perpendicular to the plane of mirror. So if the light ray travels perpendicularly in the plane mirror, then it will reflect back. Okay, understand here why it reflects back? Because here, when the light ray incident normally on the plane mirror, it makes a zero angle with the normal. Okay, so if light ray is making zero angle, the reflected ray will also make the zero angle. So it will reflect back in the same direction. Okay, so first light ray incident here and reflect back in the same direction. Okay, in the opposite direction to the incident ray. It is going. Second ray, I am considering the light ray originates from A point, it incident here on this point, which makes angle I little normal. Right? So, according to the laws of reflection, the light here will reflect back in such a way that I is equal to R. Okay, so second ray originates from A point, after reflection it will go in this direction. Okay? So, consider this two rays. Two rays originate from this point, after reflection by the plane mirror, they are going in this point. So, here the question is, we have to make this rays. Okay? If the rays will meet, then and then the image of the point A will be formed. But here, consider this, these two rays are diverging. Diverging rays will never meet. It means that the image of the point A will not form. Okay, so in this side, the image will not form. But if we extend this rays, extend means this dotted line, they are not the actual rays. Okay, if the mirror will not be there, then these two rays looks like they are coming from this point. Okay, so this ray and this ray will be meeting, appears to be meet at this point. They are not meeting actually. Okay, it looks like they are meeting at that point. Okay, that's why it is shown with a dotted line. In the rays, the rays are not actually meeting. Okay, which is called the virtual. So if the rays are meeting virtually, they are known as they are shown with the dotted lines. Okay? So this dotted line will show, because this is coating, the light cannot pass through this mirror because there is a coating here. So if we extend virtually, these two rays will appear to be meet at this point. Okay, so here the rays are meeting. So at this point, the image of point A will be formed. Okay, that I'm calling it A prime. Now let us take point B. Same way we can consider point. The first ray will be perpendicularly, it will reflect back in that direction. And another ray we are considering, incident on this point, it will reflect on that direction. And that two ray will meet here. We are not going to show the image of point B. Okay? Only point A we have considered. So the image of point B will form here, that we are calling it B prime, and the image of point A will be here. That is point A prime. So at the back side of the mirror, the image of object AB is formed. Okay, by reflection. And what do we say about the nature of image? The nature of the image. Nature means whether the image is real or virtual. Real means if the rays actually meet, then that image will be the real image. And if the rays are not actually meeting, virtually they appear to be meet. Okay? They are not actually meeting here, but it looks like they are meeting them. So they are virtually meeting. So that image will be the virtual image. So this image will be virtual. The nature of the image will be virtual. And another thing, whether the image is erect or inverted. Erect means this one. See, AB here and A prime, B prime. Okay. If the image is erect, then we are writing it erect, and sometimes the image is inverted. Okay. So for the inverted image, the nature will be inverted. So here for the plane mirror, the image is erect. Yes. So the nature of the image will be virtual and erect. Now what is the position of the image? Where the image is formed? At the back side of the mirror. So So position of the image we can write at the same distance on the back side of the mirror. Yes, every time the image, this distance will always be from mirror, or whatever distance the object is, the same distance the image will be from. And we have experienced this when we see in the mirror, the same distance we are, the same distance the image appears to be. So yes, at the same distance and on the back side of the mirror. And what is the size of the image? Size of the image. It appears that it has the same size as the object. So this is how the image is formed by the plane mirror. So for the image formation, we have learned some terminology: virtual image, real image. First one, for the definition of virtual and real image, if the image can be formed on any screen, okay, that image will be the real image. And if the image cannot be formed on any screen, that will be the virtual image. When you see in the mirror, your image is formed on the back side of the mirror, okay? But if you keep any screen, can you get that image on the screen? No. At back side there is nothing. Yes, that kind of image will be the virtual image, which cannot be taken on screen. But understand this, for the projector image, on the projector screen we are getting that image, right? So that kind of image will be the real image, where the rays are actually meeting and they form the real image. So by the plane, we have seen the image formation by the plane mirror. Further, we will learn the image formation by the spherical mirrors, okay? But before that, we will learn what is spherical mirrors, the types of it, and the terms related to it, and then the image formation of spherical mirror. So read up to this, and still if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.